this piece of plywood, I've nested in here and made this very solid. This is a piece of 1/4-inch plywood. And I've put supports here and here across the top, and it wedges into a groove down here as part of this base. To make this quite solid to be a motor mount, ordinarily this is just a little piece of 1/8-inch plywood that just covers this up. It's got some sound holes cut in it, and it just covers the back of the organ for show. In this case, this is going to be structural. This is a motor out of a window regulator for a car. Actually, I have two of these. One's a left and one's a right. And I need to get this in here somewhere about in this position, I think. In here, there's usually three of the largest pipes for the organ that are mitered and curved around in here. And I'm going to have to change that configuration a little bit to give room for this. This will be sticking out through the plywood, and there'll be a belt drive that comes up to this. And I'm not sure, this size could change, but this will be locked onto the shaft and it'll be attached to the cranking wheel. You loosen the 5 screws, and then this will come out of here. There are 2 pieces of oak that screw into this part of the base and form a groove. This piece of plywood drops down in there and then just pushes in here, a nice tight fit. This is a side window motor. This is what raises and lowers your side windows in the car. This is a splined output from a worm drive. This does not turn, just that gear turns. If I take a piece of wood, make it just about right to fit onto these teeth, and this hole just fits on that shaft, push that down onto those teeth. Then that's turning pretty close to 90 RPM. You'll never hear that on the organ. The organ will drown that out. Now, these are not necessarily continuous duty motors, but that organ's only going to be playing for a few minutes at a time. So I don't think they're going to get too hot. And there's a lot of power here. And then there would be a groove machined in here for an O-ring type belt drive. This is turned to 90 RPM. We want the crankshaft to turn about 60. So the pulley on the crankshaft will have to be a little bit larger, about 1.5 times the diameter of this. This will work if you take the time to put a slight taper on this to match the taper on the splines, a little epoxy on this, push that down on there, and when it's cured out, you may have a little difficulty getting it off there, but it will work. When you're at the auto salvage yard and you find this, take a little extra time to find the matching part from the regulator that goes on that spline. And this is the cable winch drum for the regulator. Might look like that, or it might look like this one. They all work the same. Little different sizes for different size windows. Once you determine what diameter this needs to be, you probably put this in a lathe, turn that down to this diameter here, which would correspond to this point on here. Put a wooden ring, plywood ring on there, and that would give you some tooth for your epoxy to latch on and hold on to that plywood. And then machine a groove in here to match the O-ring drive belt. The original configuration on this organ was for 5 or 6 pipes to be laying flat in this area, and the 3 largest pipes to be mitered and bent around to fill this plane. The organ was originally a bit more shallow in this area. In the front, there was a somewhat animated conductor that slid in and out the front, and with some pipes on either side. I'm not putting a conductor in this organ. I'm going to have 17 pipes in the front. That's one reason why we made this a little bit deeper, so that all the pipes would clear the reservoir and the bellows. I'm going to change the configuration on these pipes, bend them around, give me enough room to put this motor in here, and possibly lay one of the three largest pipes flat underneath the pressure box. So the next project is to build those pipes and get them in here and see how they fit. I may have to build them a couple of times to get it to work out the way I want, but we'll see how that goes.